We have to put an issue date in the voter's record, and then it takes us a couple of days from there to pack it, print the ballot, pack it, and then get it out into the mail stream. So the 21st was the first day that we could mail ballots. With a runoff, the code says as soon as possible. Well, with all of the turnaround tasks that have to happen, the 21st was the first date that we really felt we could start mailing ballots. But all of the people who had been getting ballots all year long, they are in the system and we have to give them the first day. So there were 15,000 ballots right off the bat that had to be mailed out from the rollover list, the elderly, disabled that request a ballot, you know, on every election. So those took a couple of days to mail out after the 21st. And then we started working on those that were issued on the 22nd. And what you have to do is put an issue date in the system, and then you start packing and getting ready for mailing. Well, the voter has seen the 22nd or the 21st, and they think it's already in the mail stream, but it's really not. There is a process that has to happen between you issuing the ballot and you actually mailing it out.
Some voters are saying that that happened just earlier this week, that you guys began mailing.
Well, they've been mailed all along. So on the first day, on the 21st, we had several thousand of the first 15,000 that went out in the mail. And then on the 22nd, another few thousand of that first group were mailed, et cetera, et cetera. And then you have to go back to the next day, which is the 22nd, and it may be the next week before you're getting to those, because you have to get through those first rollover voters first. So there were ballots that we issued on the 23rd that people were expecting to receive on, say, Friday or Saturday. But those ballots were issued on the day before Thanksgiving, so the county was closed on Thanksgiving and the day after. So on Saturday, we started running that report for the 23rd and packing those ballots. So those didn't actually go out until Monday, and maybe some even held over till Tuesday. And so that's quite a delay caused by the holiday when we weren't working. Well, we have 23,000 or so applications. Now, everything is mailed out, as I said earlier. But again, people see that date and they think that it is already in the mail, but it's not. It's just the date that we set it up to start the process. As all of the Georgia election officials have been saying for quite a while, and especially during the last legislative session, a four-week turnaround from a general election to a general runoff is an almost impossible task. It takes a long time to get the ballots out, to create the ballots, to print the ballots, and to get those ballots out, and it doesn't leave enough time for voters to return their ballot through U.S. Postal Mail. It's just a completely unrealistic time frame, and especially in this case for a federal office that is highly, you know, popular for people to go vote. What I would say to people who are in that situation, obviously if they are out of state, they don't have as many options, but UPSing or FedExing, overnighting it to us is certainly one of them. We will have some extra open time here at our main office for them to bring the ballot to us if they're in Cobb County or somewhere near in Georgia. We're going to be open on Saturday, the upcoming Saturday, to receive ballots here in our office, which we normally, that would not be an open day.
Okay, but that's an open day just to receive ballots,
yes.
Correct?
Correct. So we'll be open for that. We're going to open a little bit longer in the evening on Monday. We're going to be open till 6 o'clock instead of closing at 5, our usual hours. And of course, people can bring it from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on election day to our main office.